The Philippine National Police says an investigation will be carried out on the police officer whose gun was used by his own son in an accidental firing that led to the boy's death. Our senior correspondent George Carino now joins us for more on this. George, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. The Philippine National Police assured on Friday that the investigation will be conducted on the police officer whose gun was ended in the hands of his 12-year-old son in an accidental firing incident in the city of San Jose del Monte, province of Bulacan. Colonel Rodrigo Maranan, the chief of the Philippine National Police Public Information Office, told reporters in an interview that he just wants to respect the grieving family until the funeral, or when the police officer is ready, will inquire on the circumstances surrounding the accidental firing incident. You must remember that the 12-year-old boy succumbed to assault to a gunshot wound, which entered his chin, an accident in the nose, or after accidentally shooting himself inside the classroom room of Benito Nieto Elementary School at Barangay Motor. Report sent to the national headquarters of the PNP. And a statement that about 5:40 a.m. Tuesday, the 12-year-old graduate student was found with a gunshot wound in the head. Initial investigation reads that the boy is the son of a police officer. Carmina?
All right, George, as you said, the police or authorities now hoping to conduct a probe on the father of the boy, who turns out to be a cop. But what exactly are they trying to find out here? And what may be the culpability of the father here as a gun owner?
Yes. Carmina, in an interview yesterday with Colonel Ronaldo Lumacton, the chief of San Jose del Monte Police, he said that they need to find out the how and the why of the incident. How the gun ended in the hands of the 12-year-old boy, and why was it in the hands of the 12-year-old boy. But according to Colonel Lumacton, now, it's not, at that time of the interview, that was the past lunch, he said that since the boy expired around 1 p.m., it's probably not the best time to conduct a tactical interrogation on a grieving father. Carmina?
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Our senior correspondent, George Carino, there. Tell us more about this really horrible and sad news. Thanks again, George. In Cebu, police seized over 13 million pesos worth of shabu and arrested a high-value target in a buy-bust operation. Annie Perez now joins us with that story. Annie, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, authorities of the Cebu Police Provincial Office Intelligence Unit arrested this midnight a high-value target individual involved in drugs. The buy-bust operation was conducted at Sitio Bagacay, Barangay Tayud, in Consolacion Town, northern Cebu. The male suspect, who works as a motorcycle taxi driver, was snagged with over 2 kilos of suspected shabu and a street value of over 13.6 million pesos. According to CPPO Director Police Colonel Romel Ochave, the suspect is included in the top 10 list of the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency in Central Visayas. Ochave adds that he is a priority target and that they are investigating his cohorts. They have with them a drug matrix which included the said suspect. The police also discovered that the arrested can sell over 5 kilos of drugs at most in a week. The suspect also was originally a resident of Cebu City who moved to continue his illegal drug trade and is said to be part of a big group. Ochave also says they have already identified some of those involved and as they have been working on this for some time already. Follow-up operations are expected in the coming weeks after this huge haul. Last night, Talisay City cops also netted over 900,000 pesos worth of drugs at Barangay Tabunok from a worker who was already previously charged for illegal drugs. The other night before, still in Central Visayas, Bohol police officers also nabbed more than 8 million pesos worth of shabu in Dawistown. It was packed inside a Chinese tea bag similar to those of others. Authorities are looking into the source of the drugs possibly coming from Cebu province. Data obtained from the police regional office in Chance of Visayas showed that more than 2,000 grams of suspected shabu worth over 16 million pesos were seized from 161 drug personalities in 115 anti-illegal drug operations from January 16 to 23 and still counting. Cops here credited the new system that they implemented in the fight against drugs for their achievement, where there is intensified case build-up and follow-up operations. And that's the latest here from Cebu. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Annie Perez.